wondering. You may be wondering, well, I don't have a Valentine today. What to do? Maybe I do have a Valentine today. What to do? So much to ask, so much going on, such a beautiful day. And we bring on a beautiful friend of the show. Vera Gibbons joins us right now. She's the founder and editor of Non-Political News. Thank you for joining us again, fair lady.
Happy Valentine's Day.
Happy Valentine's Day to you. It is a wonderful day. I see you're adorned in pink for Valentine's Day. Thank you very much.
And you didn't get the memo about the pink
No,
tie.
I didn't. I just figured I'd let the ladies shine. If you look around, you know, there's pinks and reds all over.
Yes,
but, you know,
yes.
It is one of the things that, you know, people like you and I look at is, yeah, it's Valentine's Day, great. Are you married? You have?
No.
You're not married. No. Okay, so you don't necessarily
have mixed feelings about Valentine's Day.
Right, okay. I join you. And, you know, but the guys, people like us, we look at the money side of things.
Big day
and,
for spending.
Give us a sense of how big this is, like, you know, e-commerce, overall economy. How big is
pretty
the spending?
Big. Well, spending's going to be up, projected to be up over 30% this year, if you look at the statistics from the National Retail Federation. So we're talking overall about a $30 billion day, with the vast majority of that on the flowers, on the chocolate, on the gifts, and then about $4 billion or so on the events out, the dinners out. About a third of couples plan to go out and celebrate. You got to do something on Valentine's Day for your significant other, or you will be chopped into small pieces and buried.
Well, now, $27.4 billion is
a lot
of money, unless you're Mike Bloomberg, because that's like half of his net worth.
Right.
But if you got all the revenue from Valentine's Day for yourself, you could spend $160 million next month to run for president. So,
when you put it in that perspective.
Yeah, I'm saying, imagine that.
Imagine.
If you just got one day's Valentine's earnings for one year, you could run for president like Mike Bloomberg. What are the new trends this year? What's the hot stuff going on? I know we got the red hearts, we got the red roses, but what's
pets, that's, dogs, cats, animals. People spend.
I hope they're rescue
so
dogs.
A lot of them are rescue dogs.
But they are rescue dogs.
People are not forgetting their pets, their furry friends on Valentine's Day. They are spending a couple billion dollars, and this is up from just, you know, several hundred million 10 years ago. So that's become a big trend. And it's not just the millennials, it's the older people, the younger people, everybody's,
so
including pets.
So let me get this straight. This year, big trend is pets.
Mm-hmm.
So does this mean, well, I don't have a date, so my pet is going to be my Valentine?
Or Galentine's.
I'm going to get him some heart-shaped dog food or something like that.
Yeah. Or,
are there like pet-based gifts? Like, honey, for you, I got the dog a new jacket.
Oh, there are jackets, there are booties, there are sweaters,
there's
something for everybody.
All right.
So that's a big trend. And then the other one, John, is Galentine's Day, which a lot of people celebrated yesterday with their gal pals. So it's like groups of gals get together and they have their rosé and their lunch and their dinner and they have fun chit-chatting about things. And so it's been around for a while, but I have to say the last couple of years, more and more people are doing Galentine's Day. Not just my niece, with a G.
Galentine, like, we don't need those stinking boys.
Yeah, yeah.
The gals are getting together, and we're going to have a Galentine's Day celebration.
There's some of that. I mean, it's a lot for the, you know, the jilted single woman.
I'm down with that.
You know,
What would it be for guys then? A Galentine's Day?
I don't think they do anything. No, they barely remember to get their girlfriend flowers.
Yeah. Well, I mean, for guys that don't have Valentine's,
I think they just stay in by themselves. Or they join like dating sites. I mean, this is the time of year when you see a lot of single men, like they feel sorry for themselves and they join Match.com or
so they're swiping left,
or they're
like
on Bumble or whatever
see
they're doing. Yeah,
if
seeing
they can
what's
find
out there.
A very special Valentine. Where are the best deals? You know, if you got to buy something, you might as well get a good deal on it.
Well, there's a lot of deals going on now in general because it's the President's Day weekend sale. So you get the deals on the cars, the mattresses, the home goods, all that stuff. But then you have sort of the Valentine's Day centric deals, where if you're single and you're jilted, you can go into Hooters and get free wings if you bring in a picture of your ex. If you're looking for something to do, you could do
that. So wait, you go to Hooters, you're saying... Now, I don't know if this, you know this already, but if you look right here,
Oh.
One of the friends of the show is Iconic Brands, and they make this spirits line for Hooters restaurants.
Dark rum, I love dark rum.
We're Hooters supporters also. So I didn't know this. So guys out there, right? If you go into a Hooters with a picture of your ex-girlfriend, they give you a free bowl of wings.
Free order of wings. And then, you know, you can get a free Whopper at Burger King if you bring your ex in. They've got these drop-off boxes in select cities. So
really?
I think Hooters is actually shredding the pictures of the ex. So it's for people who have a little bit of a twisted side.
Oh, all right. Hey, look. You go to
you want free.
Got two exes. You go to Burger King, you get a burger. You go to Hooters, you get some wings.
I wonder
maybe Dairy Queen will jump in on this thing. You wash it down with a shake and you're in business.
I wonder if you bought it in two pictures of two exes, if you could get two.
Wow, yeah. Can I get a double Whopper? Now I have two exes. What are the other opportunities for the brokenhearted out there?
There's things going on
with zoos and animals.
Oh, have you seen what the zoos are doing? So, like, I think it was the San Antonio Zoo or some other zoo. So you can buy a cockroach or a rat, $5 or $25, and you name it, and they will feed it to their animals.
Yeah.
As you watch them
okay.
live, you name it after your ex, and then you watch them live
right.
stream
These,
it.
I mean, see,
it's a little
Vera,
sick and
you know, you come in with the pink shirt and everything else, and then all of a sudden you go dark on me. We're shredding ex-girlfriends and we're feeding them to animals like cockroaches.
Well, I'm single this year, so I have a little bit of anger and hostility in me.
So some of these retailers
see
all this dough getting spent.
Oh, yeah.
And they want in on the action, so they're kind of like, I guess, especially with this being falling right in line with the president.
Right.
They're extending these Valentine's specials, I guess.
Yeah, that's the thing. I mean, we had a really good holiday season, so they're kind of continuing that momentum going into the President's Day weekend. And it's these sales, they started like a couple weeks ago, and many of them will last, you know, through the end of the month. And then we have 29 days in February, so you see another slew of deals then probably. But the retailers are doing very well because people have jobs, incomes are up, wages are up, people are feeling pretty confident, the market's at a high, so people are spending and spending quite a bit.
Wow. Vera Gibbons, you are fantastic. Thank you for lighting up our show today.
Thank you.
And thank you for bringing us all the news we need to know. That's timely and on topic. You're the bomb. Thank you very much. Happy Valentine's Day to you.
You too.
happy Valentine's Day to you. Don't start going out to celebrate just yet because we got a lot more to talk about. Right after this, Joe Pignone's going to talk about it with us. I may have mentioned earlier that if you took and got every single penny spent today on Valentine's Day across the whole world, you'd have $28 million in a piggy bank somewhere, and you'd still only be worth half of Mike Bloomberg. That's a lot of money. We take a quick break. We're going to talk about Mike Bloomberg a little bit with Joe Pignone right after this.